Hello everyone, this is Cipher Deck, and today we are back in No Man's Sky. So I am finally, it took me 2 hours, 2 hours to get out of this cave. I've been going through it for a long time, and well, let's say that we benefited greatly from it. Actually, we'll go in here and you will see, and we have stacks upon stacks upon stacks of emerald, and this right here is actually not the last stack, because we have a stack on our ship as well. Oh, it's not a stack, it's a partial stack. Well, wait a minute, on the ship it can hold up to 250, and on my person, or it can hold up to 500. On my person it can only hold up, I could be here for more days. But I'm not gonna do that. It took forever to get even out of there. I see more. It's all of those cases that you see there. But we are now ship. We're now 3 minutes away from our ship. I came out of a tunnel, and I was about a minute away. I gotta follow it. Actually, it's right at the entrances too. And I've been living off plutonium. And I learned this. You can click on here and then you can click there. And it will fill it that way, so you don't have to go into this to fill it. You can just do it from here. So, this looks like it should be right inside the tunnel, so I won't go very deep. I have this madness, this thing for emerald. By the way, if I could ever find an emerald that was that big, I would be so happy. But there's emerald right up here, and then there's emerald right across the way. Oh my goodness. So, either way, we're going to end up with around 600,000 emerald in pocket. And that is if we don't have a good deal. If we get a good deal out of it, we might even get more. just more, guys. Ah. My addiction is truly even down to the dust particles. Okay. I'm gonna stop. There was another tunnel right there that has more of it. I'll get whatever it has and then I'll call that finished, because I literally, like I said, spent 2+ hours just harvest. Oh. Hopefully this is the way out. I've gotten lost many times. Okay, yeah, there's that big slab. Come out here. And then there was a lot there, and then there's a lot up there. Oh my goodness. Okay. Got to come down slowly. There we go. Yeah, and so I've been always keeping one slot open for the plutonium to power my equipment. Oh well, okay. This is about to be a finished stack. We can actually send the stack over. We now have a full 500 stack. That's 137 per stack. On the ship. We need a bigger ship is what I'm talking about, guys. So we can fit all our emerald on it. So I named this planet Emerald 2, because we have barely even scratched the surface of emerald. Look at that. That's one of those big ones. Nice. But we've barely scratched the surface of this whole planet as far as how much emerald is actually on it. So I named it Emril 2, and also I messed up on the system naming. So you'll see I have a Dexatron 1 and a Dexatron 1. Did not mean to do that. Meant to put 2. I just got ahead of myself. So either way, we know that Dexatron 1 with a Emerald 2 is actually a Dexatron 2. If that makes any sense. Okay. Scan. I feel at peace. I feel at peace? No. Okay, so let's go ahead and get out of here. Oh my goodness. The life support power has been low. Let me just say, I've spent a solid 1,000 plutonium on life support alone, and also gun ammunition. So this is actually a new place that I've just found. We'll go ahead and check it out while we're here, and then we'll go to our ship and actually finish. Oh, actually, I can't even open those. Hands are tied, as it were. Whoa, what? Destroy and get titanium out of these. What? That's a lot of titanium. Telling me, yeah, I could destroy these. Wait a minute. Yeah, I'm not gonna destroy those. I don't have any room. What I plan to do is I need Atlas passes. That's an isotope. Maybe it's plutonium. It's not plutonium. Okay, ship. Ship. We're gonna have to go to a space station to unload before we can actually continue with our main purpose on this planet. This also, the landscape on this planet is just absolutely crazy. Like I said, I spent most of my time underground. At one point, whenever I came out of being underground and going back into underground, it took me a long time to figure out where underground was again. But I was seeing all kinds of emerald under me. Oh, life support. Also, life support's been going down pretty fast. I don't know what the reason is for that. Yeah, I'm not gonna scan. Scanning is the problem. Scanning for me is literally a problem. If I see surface, I see a beam over there, but that's just, if I see surface emerald, I might go and get it. Is all I'm saying. But yeah, this has been very eventful and very profitable. And we haven't even sold the items yet. Okay, we finally made it. Let's go ahead and get in. And like I said, I think we're going to go... See, that's why you don't scan. That's why you don't scan. Anyway, we're going to go ahead and go up to the space station. And sell our goods. And we need to find it, actually. Space station, there it is. Wow, this is... Okay, so this money scheme thing of mine, this idea of getting money, is definitely taking... Oh, that scares the heck out of me. is definitely something that, yes, we need to work on, but maybe I worked on it too much. I mean, you can't have too much money, right? Oh, I'm about to hit. Oh, it took over. Never mind. Oh, man. Did another ship land? No. So whenever I was walking through those caves, the one thing that I thought was interesting is that it sounded like you were wearing heels. Like, not... I don't know if you can hear it here, but the echo really makes it loud. But it does make it sound like you have high heels on. So I'm wondering if you're playing a female. Alright, so on foot exploration 19,897. So I definitely have done well there. Alien colonists encounters, world collect words collected 5, most units accrued, and that we haven't even started selling yet, is 273,000, and sentinels destroyed is 2, space exploration is 1. So let's go ahead and sail. This is from me. This is what I have in my inventory. This isn't counting the ship. Oh, 536,000 units. We are becoming rich. We're at actually we're about to hit a million I just said platinum like EverQuest, but no, we're about to hit a million units. Wow. So nice, so fun. Oh my goodness. That took us up to 950,000 units. Just think about that for a second. And we also got this Viking effigy, but we don't, I mean, it doesn't sell well here. Though these are Viking that I'm selling to. I think I'm gonna go ahead and sell it. And I think I'm gonna sell these. We're getting close to a million. We got Geck Charm, that's 22,000. Let's see, what else? I'm trying to just clear out inventory. This, the only thing I had left on this guy was plutonium. So, and the starship should have plutonium. If I remember correctly, I thought I sent some over. Apparently I didn't. So, we now have 1 million. We have 1 million units. And this is only our third episode, guys. So a lot of hard work, a lot of time put in. We are a capitalist now. What is it, how much money is it to get, and now we're a trader. How much do we have to make to get a full circle of stars? Do they start filling in after you fill in the circle? Alright, let's take a look at this guy. Let's see what your ship is worth and what it is now that we have some money to actually roll around in our fists. So this is 21 slots. He has a lot of lot more upgrades. He has a phase coolant. He has a beam impact towel. He has another coolant. He has a beam damage sigma. And then he also has his hyperdrive, pulse engine, and all the normal things. I think I'm gonna wait. I would rather get a 25 slot ship. But let's look at this one. This looks interesting. That looks like something I would... Oh, don't get out of that. Don't get out of it. Ah. Okay, show me. Show me your things. Wow, 19 slots, only 500,000. So it is 2 slots smaller than the previous ship. It has less upgrades to it, but 500,000. I'm gonna say no to that. We are looking for a specific type of ship like that. Even though it doesn't have, has this weird thing on it. But let's look at it. Another milestone? We've traveled 20,000 units. We are a rambler now. Okay. This ship has a face that only a mother could love. I mean, that really is the weirdest kind of ship design. Alright, it doesn't meet my requirements. Bring in the big boys. Which is what that is right there. That's what I'm looking for. $1 million? One million units for this one? He's a lieutenant, so probably not going to be that cheap. Let's see, 24 slots, 1.5 million. Really? It has everything I want to. It has a beam impact Sigma. It has a coolant Sigma. It also has an accelerated fire Sigma. That's what I want. That's the dream one. 24 slots, though. So we're still looking at 2 million is what we're going to need. I can deal with that, but right now we need to try to figure out. All right, so let's check what is required from the hyperdrive. Hyperdrive requires warp cells. Can we create those? That is a question. Warp cell requires thamium 9 and antimatter. Can we buy antimatter? Yes, come on. Okay, well done. Okay, yep. Bye. And cannot buy antimatter. Alright, so let's go to... I think we're still supposed to go to a location on the planet that we never went to because I got... let's check that one. That's blue. It looks symmetrical. Okay, let's see. Come on. Interloper still. But I'm an ally to them. 25 slots, 1.8 million. Okay, it's 2 million is what I need. That's not really thinking about how long we've been playing the game. That's not really too much for us. We can actually make that money. Okay, so we need to go back to here and go straight to the beacon. Aim it up. So yeah, we can definitely get... Oh man, I'm so happy. Okay, and I'm so happy that we were able to make some money, that we are now, really? It's still gonna take a minute to get there. You know, I could be going through caves and getting emerald right now, But I'm gonna stick it out. Can we go up higher and actually reduce the time? Because in a airplane, the higher up you are, the faster it is to get to your destination. So right now, we can actually follow the horizon. Yeah. Well, did we pass it? We passed it. We're now 6 minutes away. Grand. All right, well, no shortcuts. You can see as we tip our nose up that the time is actually going down. And as we get closer, the time is going to slow down. Because that's the time relative to the distance versus the height, I think, or something along those lines. I'm not a mathematician. But now that we tip our nose down, if we tip our nose down anymore, you'll see that it's going up. And we're here. And I'm just gonna show you how addictive this is. Okay, maybe not. Alright, good. I thought this was actually in the middle of a cave, so anyway, let's go ahead and take a look at it. You see all that emerald? I mean, it's not a lot, but there is a pack of emerald on the right hand side. Okay, so now it's showing us an outpost, which is 20 minutes away. So let's go ahead and go back up to our ship. Come on, guys. How can you just show that to me right there? Can't reach it. It is an addictive situation. Even the small stuff I can see. Alright, okay. Alright, I'm turning around. let's do the job. I can always come back here and I do need plutonium though, because of our launch. The fact that there's emerald in the middle of it. And that I'm actually it. Whoa. Okay. Ship. Where's my ship? Where is my ship? Okay. Yeah. I get kind of addicted to the money and the power. And the ability to, Alright, let's take a look here. Let's get lined up first. Wow. This is one of the most barren locations that we've been to so far, but it is plentiful, and it loves me. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Oh, it actually has a, land on it. Okay. Let's go to this first. Check these out. Now that I have some inventory space open, I can open these. Oxide. Shield plate. Plutonium. Plutonium. Nada. Okay. Go ahead and save. And then we will go into here and talk to this guy, apparently. Let's see. Again, ally. Warp. The creature awaiting me has the manner of a warrior, but makes no move to attack. Instead, it grunts in a tongue I do not speak, then passes me a slate. With a start, I realize that I can understand the text on it. In disbelief, I try to catch the creature's eyes, but it has already turned away in disinterest. I suspect it is a mere courier. Not the author of this message. The slate also contains a blueprint for a new technology, a hyperdrive. Okay, so this is the hyperdrive. This is for if you started out with the red ship versus the ship I started out with, then you would have to create your own hyperdrive. But because I already have my hyperdrive, I don't need that hyperdrive. What's this? Hello? Wow, this is boosted for the bolt caster, that's for sure. Rapid fire, 68,000. Has a plus 3 tau. Let's compare them. So, wait a minute. Okay, our mining is boosted. His mining is slightly boosted, but his actual gun is what's boosted on his. Also, we have 3 slots available to us. We would have to add the analyzing visor. So, it is an upgrade. It is bolt caster based. And again, I have to go back to, if I did not have these, or I mean, look on here. I entered all 4 of these slots. It's covering all 4 of these slots except for 1. And I can actually add that. Plus, the version of the beam intensifier is boosted by 2 instead of 1. And all I would have to do is increase the, or add the beam focus sigma to here. And then you'd have the analyzer there, which would give me the ability to do 1 more boost. Yeah. 68,000. That's a stack of emerald. That's how I'm going to start looking at things until I find something that's better than emerald in price. I think it's worth it. Alright, so we got that. What's this? Multi-tool plasma launcher. Definitely something we'll want to look into. Okay, so got that. We got, what are these? Shield maximum. And like, hey, we got free units. Okay, life support keeps bringing up, so we need to check that. Plutonium. Okay, we're good. Gun. We need to add the visor. which requires iron, which is very easy to find on most planets. I don't think that's iron, is it? Wow, that's iridium? Look how it's built into the ground. You know what that means? That leads down into a cave that leads down to more emerald. Ha 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 ha. I'm kidding. I'm not really that obsessed about it. Alright, let's go ahead and get this iron. You can definitely see this is not boosted for mining. But it is, let's check this part. X. Whoa, and it has a ricochet effect. I think that was one of the things about it. Cool. Wait a minute, what is the ammo? It has 400 ammo in it. Okay. Oops. Gonna mine this. We'll get all of this iron and then we'll throw away half of it, most likely. Yep, we'll end up throwing away most of it. Okay, so we can make the visor. Let's see, what else can we make? We can add a boosted focus, which requires peridium, was it? We have peridium. Oh, hey, buddy. We have peridium right here. It's kind of weird. It's kind of weird version of peridium. Okay. Now we go in here. Okay, that adds that. Then I want to add this. I mean, I could add another boost to accelerated reload, but I'd rather have this thing, the plasma ball. It requires carbon. And this planet has no carbon on it. So, let's, it's pointing us to go back to the space station. Let's go ahead and go back to the space station. We have a little bit more emerald we can actually sell. Not too much, though. It's only 14,000 worth. So, let's go ahead and get up here. And then we'll go ahead and, get back in space. Nope. There we go. Anyone would, I mean, you wouldn't actually do this in real life, travel through an asteroid field. Whoa! Oh my goodness, I get scared every time when I see that happen. So I feel like it's gonna just bust straight into that and explode. Okay. There we go. Go up here, and it is leading me to the trading machine. So, is antimatter in here now? Let's see, buy items. antimatter. And then we have... yeah, antimatter. Let's go ahead and buy that. Ugh, it hurts me. It hurts me, but we still have 800,000. Let's go ahead and sell. Units received. Units received. And... I wouldn't want to sell those until I filled my ship up. Alright, so now we need to make a, a cell. And then put that in there. Alright, and we can go into the next, system. Oh, hello! I think we've already seen one of those. It's not within the means of which I'm looking for. This might be. Has a really cool tail section on it. It's pink though. But I only have 890,000 now, right? This is 1.2 million though. 23 slots. It's pink. Pink. B, it's a nice ship. Oh my goodness, look at that thing. Anyway, we're not looking anymore. We're getting out of here. We're gonna go ahead and get to the next star system. And we'll go ahead and probably end the video there. Let's see. M. And now we're gonna be going this way. Okay, so this is 96 light years away, and we still have 174,169 light years to the center of the universe. Let's go. I really do like this effect. Okay, there's an audio issue there, it sounds like. I don't know what it's doing. Wow, that's very odd. Maybe it's because it's traveling so far. I don't know. Or maybe the speed? I can't see any speed on my gauges, which would be nice to know how fast this is actually going. This is a tunnel forever. Wow, it is actually lasting a long time just to get there, but it is 98 light years away, so it is further than we've traveled since we've started the game. So maybe it is caught in a loop. I don't know, the audio issues were odd. Maybe it wasn't audio issues, maybe it was actually how it's supposed to sound. But it is traveling for some time. And oh, I thought it was gonna be there. Here we are. Oh wow, we are here. System undiscovered, of course. We have big ships over there. We have, oh, we have craft more warp cells for hyperdrive. Acquire antimatter formula. Oh, so we'll actually be able to make the antimatter for ourselves. That would be very beneficial. So let's go ahead and do a scan. See if anyone wants to talk to us. Manufacturing facility. This way. Tushy? Oh, wrong button. Let's go ahead and go. 33 seconds to get over there. We'll go ahead and land, and then we'll probably go ahead and end the video. I'm pretty sure this has been going for a while. These videos probably will, just because I'm trying to get a lot done in each video. I just want you guys to see as much of this game as I am, but I also am trying to get through the game as fast as I can as well. Well, that's not true. I'm enjoying the game a lot, which means when I enjoy a game this much, I want to play it as much and as often as I can. And that is honest. I mean, that's how I think a lot of people are, that they want to experience the game. And so that is the same thing with me. This looks like a lava field. Okay, weather is sunny, of course. Regular sentinels, high flora, undetected fauna. How much fauna does it expect here? No, none, zero. We get no bonuses here. Okay, this is where we need to be, but I'm gonna go ahead and end the video here. Hopefully you enjoyed, and I will talk to you next time. This is Cipher Deck. Peace out.